the thing to do, you know. It was the thing to do because it got you high. Can you dig it?
I feel you. No, that's why I'm doing it. I feel it. Man, you're cool as shit, mister. I hate to do it, but I gotta charge you. That's 60 bucks.
60 bucks?
Yeah.
Man, I remember when a dime bag cost a dime. You know what I mean? You know how much condoms used to cost back in them days?
How much?
I don't know. We never used them.
A lot of people became concerned with drugs for the first time in the 60s because young people were using them with such seeming freedom and recklessness. They were particularly concerned about marijuana.
The new federal law is on firm constitutional ground, unlike the self-incriminating tax of 1937. But still, marijuana use does not end. It just becomes illegal and finds a place in a subculture of its own that includes a comedy troupe and a magazine. Unlike pot, methamphetamine is not completely illegal. It can still be prescribed by doctors, but illegal, non-medicinal use is at an all-time high.
It's estimated that by 1971, so many amphetamine pills were produced illicitly that there were if you gave them to every man, woman, and child in the country, you would give them 50 apiece.
Methamphetamine is banned for non-medicinal use. Still, it is manufactured illegally in all 50 states. Missouri and Utah can claim the dubious prize as meth lab capitals of the U.S. Naively and innocently put on the market as the Benzedrine inhaler almost 70 years ago, no one could predict amphetamine's damage.
People who used a lot of amphetamines tended to be trigger happy about violence.
We use cannabis, you know. We use herb. Herb is the healing of the nation. Like old alcohol is the destruction of mankind. Herb is the healing of the nation, you know. The more you accept herb is the more you accept Rastafari. You dig what I say? We who accept herb. Herb is important, but herb is more important to the people who don't accept it yet, because that is a reality. I mean, it's not so well then is something that you crave, but you check it in your sense and say, herb. Herb is a plant. I mean, herbs are good for everything. Why these people who want to do so much good for everyone, who call themselves governments and this and that, why them say you must not use the herb? You see? And we check that and we can't find, we just see them just say, no, you mustn't use it because it make you rebel. Against what?
Excuse me while I light my spliff. Oh God, I got to take a leap. From reality, I just can't drift. As a while, staying with this rip. Take it easy. Got to take it slow. Take it easy. Scam can take it slow. Tell you what.
Herb is a thing that give you a little time for yourself so you can live if you use it.
running across the Rio Grande Valley, they're almost hard to spot. Yet nestled in the earth is a series of homes like nothing else.
I call it biotexture because I don't think architecture is even coming close these days.
They're called Earthships, and their green design is the brainchild of Michael Reynolds.
It's not like an idea that came like that. It's like a long, slow process of responding to the world around us and the needs that it presents.
For more than three decades, Reynolds has researched and developed self-sufficient housing made from recycled materials.
It started, like I said, with can houses. The first can house I got the idea to build, I talked to a much older engineer, sort of my elder, so to speak, in a bar, told him the idea I had, and he got mad and stormed out and said I was a disgrace to the profession of architecture.
But Reynolds wasn't fazed. In the 1970s, he built his first Earthship and went on to build the first Earthship community just outside Taos, New Mexico.
People thought I was crazy, just incompetent, stupid, insane, whatever.
The logic behind an Earthship design is simple, with each one constructed using six basic principles. Power generation, water harvesting, and sewage containment and treatment must all be on site. Heating and cooling is done without using any fuel. There's an area for in-home food production, and each Earthship is built using only recycled materials.
And all of this is trial and error development, but it took 30 years. After doing this for 35 years, I just now feel like we know what we're doing.
Earthships are constructed partially underground, which helps with temperature control. But the key is tires. To build the walls of an Earthship, tires are packed with dirt and pounded together.
So why use trees when you can use tires? But nobody can imagine how to use tires. But if you take a tire and beat it full of earth, it becomes a steel-belted, rubber-encased, thermal-mast, resilient brick.
Once the tires are in place, plastic bottles, tin cans, and glass are stuffed in every nook and cranny to fill in the walls. Once the walls are in place, it's onto water. Remember, no wells allowed. So that means each Earthship is designed to capture and recycle rainwater. That water then gets used for everything from taking a bath to flushing the toilet to making ice cubes. Here's how it works. As rain falls on the roof, it's channeled to a cistern where it's filtered. The water is then saved for drinking and other household needs. But it doesn't stop there. Water from the sinks and showers, called gray water, is harvested again and sent to what's called a botanical cell.
You take a shower, it runs through this system, waters all these plants, produces all this food, is totally contained. We gather it again, only it's much cleaner after going through all of this. We suck that back up to flush the toilet with. In other words, we flush the toilet with water that you took a bath in yesterday.
Toilet water, or black water, does go into a conventional septic tank, but it's later pumped out to the yard where it's recycled through an outdoor botanical cell, an area of landscaping specifically designed to filter and clean water.
It is actually, I have to say, fun to learn all of this. We had to learn how to build out of garbage. We had to learn how to harvest energy. There was no books when we first started doing it.
While learning how best to build an Earthship was difficult, Reynolds says it still wasn't the hardest part.
The hardest part used to be the permission to do it, and it still is. Like, permission from the authorities to let you build out of garbage and run sewage through your living room. 30 years ago, I'd have to sneak out in the woods to do this.
Just as Earthships can be designed for any climate, they can also be designed for any price range. For someone who wants to build an Earthship themselves, construction plans start at around $5,500. And for someone who wants a more lavish design, constructed by professional builders, Earthships can cost nearly $500,000.
So the bottom line is this building, with all of its systems functioning, costs maybe 10 or 15% more than a conventional home. But the conventional home would have a $600 or $700 a month utility, power, water, sewage bill, heating, cooling. And this home wouldn't. So when you take your mortgage payment plus your utility bill and call that your living expenses, these homes net a cheaper way to live.
Whatever the budget, Reynolds hopes his green earthships will help pave the way to a more sustainable future and show homeowners everywhere that they can make a difference.
You were said just a moment ago, I said, where are you living? And you said you're in between Minnesota and Mexico, but you have a fully solar-powered home.
In Mexico. That's correct.
What's your solution to the energy policy?
Well, definitely anything that we can do to get away from, you know, the oil industry, I think, is a positive. We've got to look for a long-range future plan.